Okay, now we get ready for a legend in the world of jazz. He's laid back tap dancing style, has taken him all the way from the Cotton Club to the stage at the Covent Garden Opera House. He's almost single-handedly turned hoofing into an art form. Please welcome Will Gaines!
Will Gaines, the man!
Larryl.
Hello, Will.
Gosh, it's good to see you again. Yeah. We've danced many times together.
Right.
What I've never found out, you came over here in
1963.
What was the reason you came over?
Well, I'd done the Cotton Club show, and what had happened is Norman Miller and Sammy Davis was here.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
And they asked for a clean dancer. Now, whatever that meant.
You're definitely
the next thing I know I was here. Because before I'd been over for the USO, for the American Entertainment.
Because Sammy came in 59-60.
That's right.
You came in 63.
Yes. And because of the Cotton Club show, I'd made a little name for myself. Working with Martha Ray, Eartha Kitt, Pearl Bailey, opening act. I was an exclusive opening act.
Yeah.
I thought I'd drop them in, yeah.
Absolutely. But when you were first starting, who were your idols? Who did you, when you say, I want to dance like so-and-so?
The people that's watching you and listening to me would not know, maybe some, man called Teddy Hale. But the people that I really listened to was Bud Powell, Duke Ellington and Louis Armstrong, because of the old records. But Sonny Stitt. See, that's it. It wasn't. I was listening to the jazz. I would listen to a record, run to the club, and then dance. And remembering what he was playing.
Fantastic.
Which at the time.
Like Ella would sing the notes, like you would dance.
I thought you would never say it.
There you
go. That was that era.
But you see, I was fortunate enough a couple of years ago, I worked with the Nicholas Brothers.
Oh, yeah. Harry, I want to see it. Yes.
Fantastic.
Used to hang out in Paris. Yes.
I know Harry, and they were just wonderful.
Yes.
And Tip Tap and Tap.
Yeah.
Do I know the names?
I'm supposed to get loud. I'm on television.
Now, there's a wonderful story I want you to tell when you were in Canada
about
the Queen and Prince Philip.
Before she was the Queen. Right.
Oh, really? Tell me that story.
But see, what happened was, I didn't know at the time. I was working in a place called a Snake Pit.
Yeah.
We had a Frenchman who was the boss, and he would put us in the dressing room downstairs, and he put microphones, and he didn't speak English. So I don't know how the hell he translated, you know what I'm saying? But the thing was, across the way was a club called Rockheads. So he must have been very famous with the Queen and the Duke at, you know.
Princess Elizabeth at the time.
Yeah. But they would do their business in the daytime, you know, embassy, whatever. And then at night, they would want to swing, because this Queen is a... Well, like I said, she's a queen. But she wasn't the Queen. And you talk about whatever was going.
Whatever was going.
She was doing it, baby.
Yes, I see.
But the thing was... Rockheads would have to close the club down and just allow the princes in and the Duke at the time, you see, when he wasn't the Duke. But the thing was...
Yes, he was the Duke.
Was he? Yeah, oh, good. They all look like him in the daytime, you know.
He was Prince Philip, actually.
Oh, I see, sorry.
Yeah, right.
It was the Queen Mother that was the Queen.
Yeah, right.
I did a show for her as well.
Anyway, so
the thing is, the club would lock him. Now, we next door, you know, we didn't hear about them the next day. But Oscar Peters, as you know, is a teacher.
Oscar Peters, the best.
He was a teacher.
Oh, really?
And they would wake him up at 3 o'clock in the morning, because that's the Queen today.
Yeah.
The princess would only have him to play music for her. And what's the husband's name?
Philip.
That's the one, yes.
Yes.
So you can imagine Oscar Peterson getting up to play jazz to some, and they have to go off to college. Is that beautiful?
That is wonderful.
And but a couple of days later, because I'm working with a man called Pinckney Roberts, he was the compere.
You've done Royal Command performances, haven't you?
Well, no, you did them for The Lady Be Good with Joe Chisholm.
That's right. I used to do an act and everything with my girls, but I never had the privilege and the wonderful thing of having your own band. May I meet them, please?
Would you please? Yes. Would you please?
I think I know this gentleman. How are you? Nice to meet you. It's a pleasure to meet
Frank
you.
Frank Holden.
You?
Hi
there. Dave, nice
Dave
to see you.
Ray Ward.
Now, where are you playing at the moment? What are you doing at the
moment? Well, at the moment, I'm out of work. I'm playing with you.
That's definitely it.
I did the show last night.
You did.
And you had this lady who came and saw, because that's the, I don't really tell that story.
She told me you were sensational.
Because of the Queen's 50 years, you know. Well, and me doing 50 years of bebop.
That's right, bebop dancing.
Yes,
you
yes.
Do. Now, I don't do bebop dancing.
No.
I'm a tap dancer. Fed Astaire is
Give me that Fed Astaire rubbish.
And of course.
Because I know you work with a man.
The man. My best friend, Sammy Davis.
That's right.
And that was fantastic working with him. And he had a way of... Now, I'm self-taught. Were you self-taught?
Right. By the musicians, again.
The drummers.
They would play dump, 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 jump, dump, 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 dump. And I thought it was me.
Well, wonderful.
Will Gaines and the gang there. Hang on a minute. Will, how old are you, Will?
Should I lie about it or tell you the truth?
tell me the truth. How old are you?
70 next April of 6.
70. Oh. Let's hear it for Will. Woo.